Resilience, perseverance, and persistence. These are just a few tools required to rebuild our Spokane community following a global pandemic. Hi, I'm Councilmember Betsy Wilkerson. On behalf of the City Council and our city administrators, we would like to share with you a series of local businesses and organizations that, with the help of the American Rescue Plan dollars, we were able to recover and remain in business by successfully overcoming the hardships of the COVID pandemic. As a city, we were in the perils of surviving, and now we're relieved to be on the road to thriving.
Family Promise, our mission is to equip families and communities to end the cycle of homelessness. We work with families that are at risk of homelessness, and we consider a family anybody that's caring for a child. So anybody that's at risk of homelessness or experiencing homelessness currently in Spokane County.
We envision a community where no child has to experience homelessness. And so our goal is to reach out to those families wherever they are at, be it at our emergency shelter or, you know, where they're living doubled up or, you know, in crisis, and help them stabilize their housing or find new housing.
Family homelessness is something that's overlooked in general in our community. Like, most people don't even recognize that there is family homelessness, because when you picture somebody that's homeless in your mind, you're usually picturing like a single man on the street. But pre-pandemic, in 2019, there was 3,108 homeless kindergarten through 12th grade students in our county. We've seen those numbers fall and then rise again coming out of the pandemic. They fell for a while because, you know, landlords couldn't evict folks that weren't paying on rent, and people were a bit more flexible during the pandemic. We also had a lot of rental assistance money, which now that money is almost all gone, if not totally gone at this point. And so we're seeing a lot more families now than we did pre-pandemic. We've increased the size of our shelters during the pandemic from 60 beds to 109 beds a night. And we're seeing a higher severity of homeless experience really right now.
And I would definitely elevate and reflect that. You know, we're certainly seeing more need and a higher level of needs. The barriers to families staying in housing or finding new housing have only increased. On the positive side, during the pandemic, all of the, you know, our friend organizations, including the city, have really learned how to work together to, you know, solve individual cases as well as larger scale projects. And so that's part of what we're experiencing right now, is this wellspring of support for all of the agencies working together.
So we're really excited about this Launch Northwest partnership. We were actually on the planning committee for Launch Northwest, and it was really interesting to be invited into the education circle, because usually the homeless circle and the education circle are two different groups. But really, over the past couple of years, we've worked more together. And Launch Northwest, with their initiative to increase graduation and post-secondary education enrollments, connecting with us, our kids, homeless kids, are 3 times more likely to drop out of school than children who haven't experienced homelessness. And so our kids are the least likely to graduate and therefore the least likely to go on to post-secondary education. And so the connection makes a lot of sense when you talk about it like that. So we're excited for the partnership in what is to come. We're also excited to see really what this means for generations. Because like we said, our mission is not to provide a shelter bed tonight for a family. It's to end the cycle of homelessness for generations. And education is one way that that happens.
I'm very excited because families, as Joe said, are one of the kind of invisible homeless categories in a lot of ways. And part of that is because a lot of families are living in unstable situations or doubled up, or you know, they're moving a lot, bouncing, couch surfing, and that makes it hard for them to access a lot of more traditional homeless services. There are housing programs in town that will only serve them if they are literally homeless, and that becomes a challenge. So for us to be able to work with those families that are unstably housed or hidden and to meet them, you know, through their students that are in these schools is going to greatly expand our ability to meet the needs of the community.
Yeah. So starting next year, we're really starting now, but and moving on into next school year is we will have case managers on high school campuses. This is one. We're at North Central right now, also at Shadel Park, and then two high schools in the Valley. Which will allow us to engage those students and their families a lot earlier in the process, which hopefully will decrease the amount of those families that need actually to stay at a shelter and help them stabilize in their current environment or help them find permanent housing prior to needing the more expensive, more costly, and actually more traumatic shelter experiences or sleeping in cars and things like that. I think we're moving out of the pandemic, but we're not there yet. A lot of those safety net measures that came through the pandemic, the Treasury funding for rental assistance, the extra protections around renters, all of those are expiring now. So really, we may not see the full effect of what the pandemic did for another 6 to 9 months. But I think within the next year, we will fully know what that full impact is and was, and we'll have what this is where we're going from here forward. Yeah. So the ARPA funds that are coming from the city are passing through Launch Northwest to help support having these case managers on school campuses, which is fantastic, but it's not just us. It's linked to all of these other education-based outcomes and other nonprofits so that we're leveraging ARPA funds in addition to a WASAC grant, which is a challenge grant to increase graduation outcomes, and partnering those two things together for the first time really ever to provide these types of resources in collaboration. And so I think that's super unique and should have massive outcomes. I mean, even if it's just a handful of families, which it won't be, it'll be a lot more than that, but I mean, one child that doesn't drop out of school, that graduates, that goes on to post-secondary, whether it's trade school or college, and then has a stable environment after that, I mean, it changes an entire family's trajectory. So.
And one of the most powerful things coming out of this is the coalition itself. You know, in order to create a program of this magnitude, you know, you would need almost a, you know, university level of experience and staff. But by bringing all of the different programs with their expertise together, it not only allows us to, you know, fund that program as a larger group, but also it allows all of the expertise to be brought to bear on the problem more quickly. And having all of those experts in the room is going to get us moving much faster than trying to create one organization that would be able to do it all.
You know, I think there's a lot of hot button issues around these topics that we're talking about, you know, about homelessness, about education right now. And we're in the midst of a political season. But I think there's one thing that we can all agree on is we don't want to see kids on the street. And so it doesn't matter where you're coming from on this. I think this program and this opportunity, this pilot could really show the way forward on engaging this issue in a way that is not based off of opinion, but on real fact of what really the outcomes were, and so that then we can make really wise decisions moving forward on how we appropriate resources. And I think this additional funding that did come because of COVID, we might see great benefit from that, from learning from what we do now for generations to come, really.
We now have the opportunity to try programs and try approaches that we wouldn't otherwise without funding and partnerships like this. And I believe that coming out of it, we will have learned new lessons as well as gained new tools so that even after, you know, the world continues moving on and, you know, ARPA money isn't there, that what we've learned continues to inform our approach in supporting the entire community.